Hey guys, this is Ray with Phone Arena. I'm here at Samsung's event at MWC 2014. Right now, of course, I'm taking a look at the Galaxy S5, the latest flagship Android smartphone at the manufacturer. And in this video, I just wanted to show you guys some of the new, the cool camera features in the S5's camera. You know, it has a new 16 megapixel camera with LED flash. So let me just show you some of the new tricks that this bad boy can do. Now, first of all, we have a bunch of camera modes here. You know, the user interface is simplified, which is pretty cool. There is the dual camera shooting mode, which we already know, I guess, from previous Galaxy smartphones. There I am, and that's enough of me there. So I'll revert to auto mode. Okay, so we are back to auto mode, and one of the coolest new features is real-time HDR. It's activated by pressing this key here, and as you can see, now I'm pressing it, and what it does, it automatically shows you what is going to happen once you attempt to take that HDR photo. So it's in HDR mode, like in real time. You know, on the iPhone 5s and other devices, you just turn on HDR, take a picture, and then see what's going on. But with the GS5, you don't have the option to check out the results immediately, even before shooting. So once again, I'm turning it on, and you can see how the darker areas kind of start to come up and become more visible, which is HDR, what HDR does best. Turning it off right now, everything gets the darker areas get a little darker, you know. I guess that's probably not the perfect scene to showcase this feature, but still, you get the point. I activate HDR, darker areas, you see the black jacket over there, became much more visible. So that's what HDR does, allowing it to take higher dynamic photos more easily. And it even works for video, so you can now take HDR video. Another new feature is the 4K video recording with the GS5. You can shoot standard 1080p, or you can go for Ultra HD or 4K, as they call it. It's very simple. You just select the mode, press the record key, and just start recording the 4K video. So the last feature that I want to showcase right now is called selective focus, and it's a bit harder to pull off. Right, so I'm just gonna try to show you how it works. I'm activating it by pushing this button here, and now the thing is that we're going to take a picture of an object which is close to the camera, and the idea of this feature is to kind of increase the contrast in terms of depth between the object and the background as it's shown on this picture. So kind of artificially increase the depth of field, you know, make that shallow depth of field effect, like on quality DSLR cameras. So let me try this now for you. I'm gonna take a picture of the Gear Fit, which I have right here. So I wait the phone to focus on the Gear Fit, which is on the foreground. I'm taking the picture. Okay, it's processing it, and unable to apply focus contrast effect, subject not detected. So it obviously didn't work for us this time. Let's try it. Let's give it another try. See if it if we can get this to work. So we have our subject here on the foreground. I'll try to bring it even closer to the camera. Taking a picture. Processing. It's taking a little longer this time, so hopefully it's going to work. Yes, it worked. So now, as I access this image right here, there it is, the Galaxy Fit in the foreground. Let me try and make this a little bit more visible for you guys by dialing down the brightness. So the Galaxy Fit is in the foreground, and as I push this key here in the left side, I have now, and I have the option to change where the focus is put. So right now, let's go to near focus, and this means that the near object to the camera is going to be the one that's in focus. Fair focus is more of a balanced mode where, you know, the focus somewhere in the middle. Now, neither the fit, neither the background are in focus, which is bad actually. Running. And then you have pan focus, which I guess is going to work in certain situations, and it's going to put the focus on your background. But that's a pretty cool feature right here for you, allowing you to create such a shallow depth of field effect like on you know, those standalone cameras. So that was a pretty quick tour of the, some of the biggest new features in the Galaxy S5's 16 megapixel cameras. For more info, guys, just check us out at phonearena.com.